Hi everyone, welcome back to Prakashim Tutorials. In this video, I am going to discuss about the concept of coherent detection of signals in noise. Suppose capital M possible signals, that M possible signals are S1 of t, S2 of t, S3 of t and so on, Sm of t. That M possible signals are transmitted with equal probability and each symbol duration is capital T seconds. In geometric representation of the signals, Si of t is given to N bank correlator. It will generate signal vector Si. We may represent S1 of t by a point in Euclidean space of dimensions. That dimension is N less than or equal to capital M, and capital M is the M possible signal and capital N is the space of the Euclidean space, N dimensional Euclidean space. So we may represent S1 of t by a point in Euclidean space of dimension N less than or equal to M. This point is referred as the transmitted signal point or message point. The set of message points corresponding to the set of transmitted signals is called as signal constellation. And this is the definition of the signal constellation. So now here in this figure, but from the equivalent model of the AWGN channel, AWGN mean additive white Gaussian noise channel, the received signal x of t is the received signal of the AWGN channel. Whenever it is applied to the N bank of correlators, it will give the observation vector x. And it is differ from the signal vector Si by the noise vector W. We represent the received signal x of t by a point n Euclidean space to represent the transmitted signal. Once again, we represent the received signal x of t by a point in n dimensional Euclidean space to represent transmitted signal. This point is referred to as a received signal point. So that received signal point as shown in this figure. So now here in this figure, and x is the observation of the vector, s suffix I is the signal vector, and this is the message point, and this is the received signal point, and this is noise vector W. Okay, so in this figure, let us consider the equivalent model of the AWGN channel. In that AWGN channel, x of t is the received signal. Whenever it is applied to the N bank of correlators, and it will give the observation vector x, and it is differ from the signal vector Si by the noise vector W. We represent the received signal x of t by a point in n dimensional Euclidean space to represent the transmitted signal. This point is referred to as a received signal point. Suppose given the observation vector, x is the observation vector. Given the observation vector x, we make a decision as m cap is equal to mi. So mi is the output of the reconstructed signal. So we make a decision as m cap is equal to mi. So here the probability of the error in this decision is given by p of mi by x is equal to probability of mi not sent is equal to 1 minus probability of mi send, and this is the equation of the error probability in the decision device here. So So this equation can be, and this is this reference equation, from this reference equation, the optimum decision rule, from this reference equation, the optimum decision rule is given by or stated as, set m cap is equal to mi if probability of mi sent for x is greater than or equal to probability of mk sent for x for all values of k not equal to I. The equation 1 can be represented in terms of the prior probabilities of the transmitted signal and in terms of likelihood functions, and equation 2 in terms of prior probabilities. This equation 2 in terms of prior probabilities are given by, set m cap is equal to mi if pk fx of x per, x by mk divided by fx of x is maximum for k is equal to I. So fx of x is the probability density function of the random variable x, fx of x per mk is the conditional probability density function of the random variable x, and this value is maximum for k is equal to I. And equation 2 in terms of likelihood conditions are given by, set m cap is equal to mi if L of mk is maximum for k is equal to mi. And next we are going to discuss about graphical representation of the maximum likelihood decision rule. Let us consider n dimensional Euclidean space. In that space, capital Z denotes the n dimensional space of all possible observation vectors x. This is referred to as observation space. We assume that m cap is equal to m. So the total observation space Z in partitioned into m decision regions. Observation vector x lies in the region z suffix I if L of m comma is the maximum for k is equal to I. From log likelihood function L of mk gets minimum value by minimizing summation term for k is equal to I. That is, sigma j is equal to 1 to n xj minus skj whole square. From this, the maximum likelihood decision rule is reformulated as, observation vector x lies in the region ji. If observation vector x lies in the region, ji, if sigma j is equal to 1 to n, xj minus skj whole square is maximum for k is equal to I. We know that sigma j is equal to 1 to n, xj minus skj whole square is equal to squared magnitude, so double determinant of x minus xk whole square. From this equation, the decision rule is restated as, observation vector x lies in the region ji. If the Euclidean distance, double determinant of x minus sk is maximum for k is equal to I. From this equation, the maximum likelihood decision rule is simply to choose the message point close to the received signal point. So we know that sigma j is equal to 1 to n xj minus skj whole square is equal. So now we are applying the a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab, and applying the summation into each term, we get RHS term is sigma j is equal to 1 to n xj square plus sigma j is equal to 1 to n skj square. s k j square minus 2 sigma j is equal to 1 to n x j into s k j. In this equation, the first term is independent of index k. And from this equation 9 and equation 8 is rewritten as observation of vector lies in the region zi. Observation of vector x lies in the region zi if sigma j is equal to 1 to n xj s kj minus 1 by 2 e suffix k is maximum for k is equal to I. So therefore, the energy signal Ek is equal sigma j is equal to 1 to n s kj square. From this equation, for an AWGN channel, the decision regions are regions of n-dimensional observation space Z bounded by linear boundaries. And this is the concept of graphical representation of the maximum likelihood decision rule.